Hi, everyone. My name is Brian Emerson. I'm the Vice President for Enrollment, and I am joined today by Tashieka Thompson. Tashieka is a recent graduate from our music program. Tashieka, congratulations on graduating.
Thank you. Thank you.
How does it feel to be done with your college career?
It feels great. I'm excited.
Good. It was kind of a weird ending to the semester. I mean, we spent half of the semester not on campus. How did you adjust during that time period?
I think I adjusted okay. It took a little bit. I was kind of moping around, being a brat about it. I wanted to be on the campus, but the staff at Villa is awesome, so they helped a lot with the transition.
That's great to hear. Well, you made it. Congratulations. It wasn't easy, but you did it. So we're proud of you.
Thank you.
Yeah. So tell us a little bit about your Villa experience. You were a transfer student, right?
Yeah. I came in with credits from Hilbert College.
All right.
And so I ended up doing 3 years at Villa instead of four.
That's cool. What was different about Villa? Like, how did you find your fit at Villa in that experience?
What was different about Villa is because, I mean, for one, you guys have a music program, and music is something that I absolutely love to do. I love to sing, and I just wanted to enhance, you know, those skills and get more into the theory part of it. And I just felt like Villa was the right fit. It was small. It's Christian-based. And a lot of the values are some of my own.
Excellent. Yeah, that's awesome. I have to say, Tashieka, you have a beautiful voice. You are one heck of a singer, probably one of the finest I've ever heard at Villa. So
thank you.
It was always a pleasure to hear you sing. And I know there's some videos out there on social media of you singing as well that the college posted recently. What made you decide to study music at the collegiate level?
So my whole family sings, on my dad's side. And, it was kind of like, some people are kind of like, oh, music, don't go to school for music. But for as much as I tried to run away from it, it always kind of like came back and smacked me in the face. Like, this is what you're supposed to be doing. And I remember I was taking, voice lessons at Elmwood Community Music School. And then, the staff over there, they're just so awesome. And they were still like doing things within the community and like other projects that they were working on. And I was like, well, wait a minute, I could do that too. And some of them were still, you know, teaching college courses and whatnot. And that's actually where I met Gary Rakowski at the community music school. And so I was kind of like, yeah, I'm going to go back to school for music.
Nice. Yeah, Gary Rakowski teaches at Villa, a longtime faculty member. You know, it's funny listening to people because sometimes they'll tell you like, oh, you better not study music. You better not study English. You better not study this, that. And like sometimes I know this is probably not like what maybe your parents want to hear, but sometimes you have to follow your heart, right? Like you've got to see where those passions go and try to make a life of it, right?
Right. No, I agree.
So what kind of music inspires you? How did you get started with music?
In the church. My family is very rooted in the church, faith-based, Christian values. And I've sang gospel like almost all of my life. I like R&B. Coming to Villa helped me get more into jazz, so I'm a fan of that. And then rock. I can't leave that out because I had shied away from rock ensemble for the longest, and then once I gave it a go, I'm like, oh yeah, like I like it.
So for those of you who are not familiar, Villa has a rock ensemble that you can take as a class. And let me tell you, those concerts are awesome, and I want to sign up for rock ensemble myself. Yeah, that's cool. I mean, so many people get their start singing as a kid, you know, in the church or at any age, really. You know, it's such an awesome way to perform and also to use your talents to you know, help build the community and to honor God. That's pretty awesome way to get started. What do you hope to do with your music degree? Like, where do you see yourself performing? What do you see yourself doing?
So actually I would like to be on stage. I had auditioned for the Theater Alliance of Buffalo, TAB, back in, I think it was December, but because of everything that's happened, I haven't heard anything back from them, and I don't know if they're even going to have a season now, and, but I'm crossing my fingers, so hopefully I can get into some musical theater, and then I'll resume my place in the soprano section with the Buffalo Philharmonic Chorus. And I don't know, maybe teach at a local college, some fundamentals, stuff like that, voice lessons. Just, I want to give back.
Excellent. Yeah. You know, we really hope to see the arts community pick back up here in Western New York after, you know, the pandemic. We can make some progress on how we're going to reopen and do those types of things. But we do hope to see the arts community bounce back in full strength. There's a really strong community here in Western New York. And it would be excellent to see you be a part of that as well. So those are some cool plans. I like that. You mentioned one of our professors, and, you know, we know that the music department at Villa is a lot of close-knit students, a lot of faculty who are also kind of out in the music world, performing, teaching, doing all sorts of cool things like that. What faculty, how did your experience with those faculty members shape you?
Wow. That's interesting that you asked that. I just spoke to Essen Gundes a couple of days ago, and she's a adjunct there, a voice teacher. And I mean, just all of the music department, but like to name a few, her in particular, Linda Appleby, Sylvia, Sister Barb. I can't forget Sister Barb. but like, they've helped me out tremendously as far as like, oh, when I came to Villa, like everybody they're always like, oh, you have such a great voice, you can sing. And I mean, honestly, when I came there, I didn't really think I had too much going on. And
come on, really?
Like, I wasn't that sure of myself. Like, okay, like I knew I could sing, but I'm like, yeah, it's not what you guys are saying. It is. And the faculty there really, like, especially Sylvia, Linda, and Essen, like, they really helped me to, like, dig deep down and find that confidence and believe in the gift that I have and my abilities. And then Sister Barb, like, if you do not understand theory, she will make sure you get it before you leave. And I just overall, like, I talk about breath control with different people. When I came in, I did kind of think I knew. I thought I knew what I was doing, or like I had it together, but I did not. A couple of lessons with Essen, and you'll realize, no, you do not. So
you came in.
I had to be, I don't know, reworked out.
That's a really cool story of growth. And, you know, you might have come in maybe doubting yourself a little bit, and now you're leaving a full-fledged diva, right? No, not at all. No, still humble and still growing. But that's funny. It's funny that you mentioned that. Yeah, I mean, that's the cool thing about, you know, studying, you know, anything in college, but especially music, is it's so like personal too, right? Like, music is such a part of you. Like, it's not just, I'm not just acquiring skills. Like, I'm not just like, okay, I can check off, you know, that I passed this accounting test or, you know, something else. It's so personal because it comes from you. It's a growth experience, right? Like, you come and you think you know, but then you don't know, and you build it up, and you maybe still you go through those experiences and build and you build and you build, and it's a continuous journey, which is such an awesome thing about studying music, right?
Right. I agree.
That's cool. So one of the cool things that you got to do is you were selected by the president to perform at his inauguration, you know, which we hadn't had one of those at Villa in over 40 years. That, how was that experience?
That was awesome. That's cool. That was awesome.
It was definitely a really neat experience for all of us to get to hear you sing, but probably pretty cool for you as well.
Yeah, no, I was excited. That was awesome.
Nice. So, you know, you've kind of finished your Villa career here. Hopefully we will still see you around and have you involved on campus. What kind of advice might you have for somebody who's just getting started, who's just coming in?
I would say not to be afraid to ask for help, because everyone there is overly helpful no matter what. I mean, it could be before campus opens, after hours. The staff is awesome. Just for instance, like this COVID-19 thing, you guys have gone over and beyond to make sure that everything was okay for us, to try to make it as normal as possible for us. So I would say, like, don't be afraid to ask for help, because no matter who you ask, even if they don't know the question, they'll find somebody who does know the answer to your question.
Yeah, that's awesome. Good advice. Thanks so much for sharing that and for talking a little bit about your experience today. I appreciate it.
Thank you.
All right, Tashieka Thompson, thank you for being with us. Congratulations again on graduating, and best wishes, best of luck with everything going forward.
Thank you so much.